Away from me. I said some other words, Ella Robinson.
Yeah.
I'm like, ah, you can't roll me, snake. Don't come around when the fight is over. You ain't playing no dominoes with me, you ain't drinking no beer with me, you ain't smoking no cigarette. Stay away from me! I'm serious. We need to get the cows out of our life. Why you go to church every Sunday? I go to church to get a breakthrough. I go to church to give God praise and give God glory. And to say, thank you, Jesus. You need, you're too young for all that. No, I'm not. Remember today, remember now thy creator in the days of thy youth, before the evil day come and you find no pleasure in there.
Yeah.
See, one of these days you're going to be old, can't do nothing but go to church.
Amen.
Let's move on.
Now the time was the time of the first ripe grapes.
Come on now, God, now they go there right when, right in the beginning of the first evidence of the fruit. That means there was the aroma in the air, and there was evidence on the vine. Read.
And they ascended by the south and came up to Hebron, where Ahiman, Shishak, and Talma.
You know what? That's past the that's a whole bunch of stuff. We can't worry about pronouncing. We can, and like I tell you, get the little CD. What I do is I learn how to pronounce them by listening to the Bible on audio.
Yeah.
Verse number 23.
And they came unto the brook of Eshcol.
These are the spies that Moses sent out. It was 12 of them. There was a representative from every tribe. Mm-hmm. The 10 original tribes and the 2 tribes from Joseph. Why? Because 2 of the other tribes got fired. Remember? Mm-hmm. You don't remember? Go do your research. Amen. Manasseh and Ephraim takes the place of the original, the other 2. Amen. They got fired. Their daddy fired them and he put the blessings on Joseph's children. Amen. And so the representatives from these people are now being obedient and follow what Moses said to, and now they're here. What does it say? Read.
And cut down from thence a branch with 1 cluster of grapes.
How many clusters?
1 cluster.
1 cluster of grapes. Because sometimes people say, well, you know, for 2 men to carry, they must have took the whole vine. That's not what the Bible said. The Bible said they took 1 cluster. And everybody in here can grab a cluster of grape in their hand. That's a normal cluster, but not one from God.
That's right.
See, God does exceedingly and abundantly above all we can even ask or think. Matter of fact, if you can think it, that's still too small.
Come on. That's it.
Yeah, right. Amen. And this is the trip. The devil has you limited by your thinking. He said, I can give you abundantly above all you can even ask or think.
Yes.
And we stop us at thinking. Well, I don't think I can. What about the glass ceiling, Pastor Nolan? Can you see a glass ceiling?
No.
That means it ain't there. It only exists in your mind.
Come on.
Amen. It's quiet in here.
That's it.
I remember when I first got my job, I could talk about myself because of people that don't like me talking about myself, I didn't hear anything. So. But I went to apply for this job. And the man says, Victor, we like you and we like your presentation. He said, but the 2 guys that came before you, they agreed to take the job for $2 less an hour. I said, for real? I said, well, give them the job.
Come on.
He said, what?
Yeah.
I said, give them the job. I already got a job. I came over here because I thought y'all needed me.
Uh-huh. That's it.
But if you don't need me, may the Lord watch between me and you. I didn't say that. I'm out here. I got work to do. Hold on now. Let's work something out.
Yeah.
I said, there's nothing to work out. That my offer is on the table.
Yeah.
When you can meet that offer, you have an employee.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Before I can get to the door, okay, Victor, you have the job.
Amen.
And watch this now. All the guys that had applied for the job had experience and they had already been working there.
Come on.
I ain't know nothing about a plant.
Jesus.
I came in as a truck driver.
Wow.
Amen. Uh-huh. Because my wife told me she needed more money. Well, we needed more money.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
I was was happy with my little safety job. I was working. I was happy, Brother Dave, Brother Ray. I was happy. You know how you get those jobs, the money is all right, you're comfortable, you got nice people to work with. It was cool. I mean, I had my tie on, Sister Ernestine, and my clean shirt every day. And I had to go from wearing a tie and a clean shirt to getting greasy hands and dirty. Y'all ain't here. But let me tell you something. That dirty job opened up the door for the job we have now. See, sometimes we're afraid to get dirty. I can hear that, Lord.
Come on.
Amen. God is able.
Yes, he is.
Yes.
Because let me tell you another thing they said. They said, well, you're a preacher. And the last time we hired a preacher, he was trying to get everybody saved and pass some tracts all out. They said, you ain't going to be passing out tracts all out. I said, no, I am the tract. No, I said, you ain't got the word. I ain't got no tracks in my car. Amen. No, I ain't going to be sticking that nobody to wall locker. If I talk to somebody, it's going to be face to face.
Come on, that's good.
Amen. Seriously. Amen. The first week I got the job, the plant superintendent tried to hem me up in the office. And he did not know. I've been teaching Sunday school since I was 15. And I said, okay, come on, let's go ahead. And well, what about this? I said, well, let the Bible say. We ran about 45 minutes, and we were gathering the crowd. But anyway, that's a whole other story. I messed up. I was a young man. But still, God worked that thing out.
Amen.
And the people found out I wasn't intimidated.
That's it.
So guess what? When they got in trouble and they needed somebody for a breakthrough of prayer, they came to see Victor Nolan. Amen. Because let me tell you something. When I first walked in there, these guys were walking around with swastikas on the uniforms and on their hats. This one guy says, I can trace my lineage all the way back to Hitler himself. I said, you can? I said, I looked at roofs. I can trace my history back to Kunta Kinte. But it's like whatever they had, I have a response back for them. Amen. And they look at me, I'm serious. And people will look at you and see if you're coward or not. Because see, I'm gonna tell you something. I know I'm not what the swastika say. You can say whatever you want. You ain't better than me.
That's right. Amen.
I don't care who told you you was better than me because you was white. You ain't better than me. I'm sorry.
Right.
I was raised up in an area where black folks was. That's the way I was raised.
Yeah.
So don't even get me started on my what you call me, Sister Nolan, a black racist. Read, what's it say? Come on. It says,
and they dared between the two of them.
Two men carrying the grape, read.
And they brought of the pomegranates and of the figs.
Uh huh. 26. 26.
And they went and came to Moses and to Aaron and to all the congregation of the children of Israel.
So they came back with all the stuff, the evidence of what God, Moses told me to bring back in front of everybody. Read.
Unto the wilderness of Paran to Kadesh, and brought back word unto them.
Uh-huh.
And unto all the congregation,
and
shewed them the fruit. It was, I guess, showed them the fruit of the land.
Yes, read. 27.
And they told him and said, we came unto the land. Whither thou sendest
us. We was obedient. We did what you told us to do. Read.
And surely it floweth with milk and
it's
honey.
It's just like God said it was. Read.
This is the fruit of it.
And this is the evidence. God said it. Here's the evidence.
Yeah. All right.
But read on.
Nevertheless.
That's the same thing as yeah, but.
Yeah, but.
Huh? Yeah. And see, people that use a yeah, but word ain't going nowhere. 5 years from now, they'll be still in the same spot.
Jesus.
Hear me now. God says you're healed. Yeah, but my MRI says this. The devil with your MRI.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
Good Lord. Jesus. I ain't picking on nobody up in here. Cast the devil out of your mind.
Yeah. Preach it.
Stop focusing on your frailties and focus on the author and the finisher of your faith.
Yeah.
God said it, I believe it, that settles it. Amen. Ain't nobody in here qualified by itself, but with God, we can do everything. Yeah. I believe as Paul says, I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me.
Yeah.
That leaves nothing out.
Amen.
I ain't fussing, just discussing. Nevertheless, the people what?
Nevertheless, the people be strong.
Stop right there. The people in the land are strong. So, somebody say, so what?
So what?
Even if they are strong, God is stronger. Even if they're mighty, God is almighty.
Yes.
Even if there's a king in the land, God is a king of kings.
Yes.
Even if there's a lord in the land, he's the Lord of lords. So I say, so what?
So what?
But Pastor, you don't understand how big my problem is. So what? I know the problem solver.
Yes.
And he's never seen a problem yet that he can't handle.
And the cities are walled.
And there's a wall there. Yeah, so what? Somebody say, so what?
So what?
Say, stop making excuses.
And move forward. Yes, sir.
Read.
And very great.
Big walls. So what?
All right.
These big walls are still on a big planet. That's a part of a big universe. That's in the palm of God's hands. He's got the whole world in his hands. And all God's got to do is say, shake, shake, shake. Shake the devil off. And that whole wall can come down.
That's right.
Read, what's it say? Very great.
And moreover,
get to put a little accent. And moreover, as if that's not